Hello, I'm Brian Charlson. I'm director of the Computer Training Services Program at the Carroll Center for the Blind in Newton, Massachusetts. During the next few sessions, we're going to teach you all about Apple iOS devices, from the iPad to the iPod Touch to the iPhone. I hope you enjoy these sessions. We're going to review a program called Read2Go. This is an iPhone, iPad, iPod application that you can place on one of those three devices to access the contents and services of an organization called BookShare. You can locate them at bookshare.org. The application called Read2Go is available on the App Store. Again, that's Read, R-E-A-D, the number 2, and then the letters G-O for Go. I'm going to move from my page 1 of my screen to page 2 with a 3-finger swipe right to left across the center of the screen.
Page 2 of 3, navigation folder.
Then I'm going to flick until I get to my books folder, flicking to the right.
News folder, entertainment folder, identify folder, productivity, books folder, 4 apps.
Then I'm going to double tap to open that folder.
Books.
And within that books folder, I'm going to flick to the right.
iBooks. Read2Go.
Until I get to Read2Go. I'm going to double tap to open this application.
Read2Go. Bookshelf. 3. Heading.
And I instantly hear that I'm on the bookshelf, that there are three things on my bookshelf, and that that's the heading. Across the bottom of the screen, there are 4 controls along the dock area. I'm going to move my finger up from the lower left-hand corner till I touch one of them.
Selected. Bookshelf. Tab.
And you can hear that the bookshelf tab is currently selected, and that's why we're seeing the bookshelf screen. I'm going to flick to the right.
Search. Tab. 2 of 4.
The search tab will allow us to go to the BookShare program and service and look for books. We'll be doing that in just a moment.
Settings. Tab. 3 of 4.
Settings will allow me to set those settings that are specific to this application, including the voice of the narrator, etc.
Help. Tab. 4 of 4.
Help will give you some documentation on how to use this application, version numbers, and indication of who is the copyright holder. I'm going to go to the top right-hand or left-hand corner of the screen, bring my finger down.
AT&T Network Bookshelf 3 heading.
Until I land on the Bookshelf 3 heading. And now I'm going to flick to the right.
Edit button.
And again.
Selected. Title. Tab. 1 of 3.
Now there are 3 tabs here that indicate what order books are going to appear. Currently it's going to list them according to title in alphabetical order. I could choose instead, flicking to the right.
Author. Tab.
To have them organized in alphabetical order by the author, or flick to the right.
Latest. Tab. 3 of 3.
Or listed by what I've downloaded the most recently versus the ones I've downloaded in the past. Actually, this is based on copyright, not on download date. Flicking to the right.
Search button.
I have a search button that allows me to search those books on my bookshelf. Since I only have 3, I'm not going to need to use that service, but I could very easily have 40 or 100, and under those circumstances, I might need to search through them. Flicking to the right.
Cooking with Fire and Smoke, Philip Stephen Schultz / Richard Pratcher.
It indicates the title of the first book on the bookshelf and who is the author. Flicking to the right again.
Face the Music, Jokes About Music, Scott K. Peterson. Children's book / entertainment.
Here it not only told me the book title and the author, but also how it was categorized. Flicking to the right.
Selected. Great Cooking Outdoors. Beverly Holzman / Gail T. Holzman. Outdoors and Nature / Cooking. Food and Wine / Nonfiction.
So this again gave me the title, the author, and what categories it was listed. It also indicated that it was, quote, selected, unquote. So that's actually the book that has the application's attention at this point. Flicking to the right.
Selected. Bookshelf.
And we're back down to those 4 choices at the bottom of the screen. I'm going to flick back with the left flick.
Selected. Great Cooking Outdoors. Beverly Holzman / Gail T. Holzman. Outdoors and Nature / Cooking. Food and Wine / Nonfiction.
I'm going to double tap on that.
Book Detail. Bookshelf. Back button.
Now we're at the Book Detail screen. I'm going to flick to the right.
Book Detail. Heading.
And we include
Great Cooking Outdoors, Beverly Holzman, Gail T. Holzman.
And it tells me the title and the author. Flicking to the right.
Read button.
I have a button to read it. We'll do that in just a moment. Flicking to the right.
Camping and canoeing enthusiasts show you how to prepare over 150 mouth-watering recipes in your kitchen to savor in the great outdoors.
And here you get a short annotation of the book.
ISBN 978-0553134544.
Here you get the ISBN number.
Date added, April 30, 2007.
And this is not the copyright date, but the date it was added to the collection.
Publisher.
It does not indicate the publisher in this case.
Copyright, 1980.
There you get the copyright date.
Categories, outdoors and nature, cooking, food and wine, nonfiction.
These are the search categories.
Language, English, U.S.
And of course, some of the books are not necessarily in English.
Selected, bookshelf.
And
tab,
we're back down to the four button choices across the bottom of the screen. I'm going to flick left till I get to the read button.
Language, category, copyright, publisher, date added, ISBN, camping and canoeing at read button.
I'm going to double tap in the center of the screen now that the read button has the focus. It's going to begin speaking, and this is not using the voice of VoiceOver or Siri. It's going to be utilizing the voice that's part of the application. It's considered a self-voicing application. Double tapping on the center of the screen.
In progress. Bookshelf button.
Now, we hear one syllable from the person or from the talking system. I'm going to put my finger on the home button, slide it up slowly.
Play pause button.
Until I get to the play pause button. Now I'm going to double tap on the play pause button to begin hearing this book.
Play. Great. Cooking outdoors. Abandoned book. June 1980. Book design. Little Chevry. All rights reserved. Copyright. Copyright. 1980 by Gail Holzman. Cover art copyright. Copyright 1980 by Bantam Books, Inc. This book may not be reproduced in whole or in part.
I'm now going to move my finger back up to that same button.
Play pause. But for
and pause it.
Band pause.
There are other controls on the screen. I'm going to flick to the right.
Next phrase button.
This would allow me to jump forward a phrase. And again, it's using pauses in the narration to indicate what a phrase is. Flicking to the right again.
Next page button.
I can jump forward by pages, assuming that the ebook itself is tagged with pages. And you can't make that assumption on individually scanned books as much as you can on those that were provided by the book publisher. Those are the last controls going to the right. I'm going to go to the left.
Next phrase.
And again.
Play pause.
And again.
Previous phrase.
Of course, if we can go forward a phrase, we can go back a phrase. Flicking to the left.
Previous page button.
And to the previous page. Flicking to the left.
Settings button.
And I can go into settings. Now, the settings would allow me to make other alterations as to what the controls will be and who the speaking voice is going to be. Flicking to the left.
Set bookmark.
At any time in the book, I can set a bookmark, and that'll make it easier to come back to it later. But I can set multiple bookmarks and navigate between those bookmarks. Flicking left.
Navigation button.
This gives me a choice to go in and change the nature of the navigation. It's currently set to phrase and page, but I can set it to other navigation levels as well. Flicking left.
Bookshelf button.
I can return back to the bookshelf to look at other books. Flicking left. And that's what I'm going to do. Double tap on that bookshelf button.
Bookshelf 3. Face the music. Jokes about music. Scott K. Peterson.
Flicking left.
Cooking with fire and smoke.
Left.
Search button. Latest.
Left.
Tab. Off.
Left.
Tab.
Left.
Selected. Title. Tab.
Left.
Edit button.
Left.
Bookshelf 3. Heading.
Okay, so I'm at the beginning of it now. I'm going to choose instead of bookshelf, search down on the bottom four choices. So I'm moving my finger up to bookshelf.
Selected. Bookshelf.
Flicking
tab.
Right once.
Search. Tab.
Double tapping on search. Search screen comes up. I'm going to move my finger down from the upper left.
Search. Heading.
And flick to the right.
Selected. Title slash author. Tab. 1 of 4.
So I have four different things I can search by. Title slash author.
Title. Tab.
Title only.
Author. Tab.
Author only.
ISBN. Tab.
ISBN number.
Title slash author. Search field.
Here I now get a search field. So I'm going to double tap to open that search field.
Search field is editing. Title slash author.
And now I'm going to put in a title. Let's say the title is... Oh, let's see. Let's pick something simple. I'm just going to type the word cook.
Space. V. C. C. K. O. 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 J. K. K.
Now, I've set my keyboard to touch typing, which meant that I can put my finger down on the keyboard in the bottom third of the screen, move it till I find that the letter I'm looking for, and then pull my finger off, and it types that letter. Now I'm going to look in the lower right-hand corner.
Search.
Where there is a search button, and I'm going to double tap the center of the screen.
Bookshelf 3 in progress.
It's now searching the database at BookShare.
Results.
And now I have a results screen. I'm going to flick to the right.
Japan took the J A P out of me, Cook.
Japan took it out of me by a guy named Cook.
Captain Cook, Frank Micklin.
Captain Cook.
Teens Cook, Megan Carl / Jill Carl / Judy Carl.
Teens Cook.
Mission Cook. Brian O'Reilly / Cold Copper Tears Garrett. P. I.
I'm just flicking to the right.
Garrett. P. Garrett P. I. Omnibus number 2. Glenn Cook. Garrett on the case. Omnibus. The education of Haley Kendrick. Eileen Cook. Accommodating Broccoli in the cemetery. Or why can't safe passage. Ida Cook. Universe lost. Reclaiming a Christian worldview. Stuart Cook. Unraveling Isabel. Eileen Cook. All in a word. 100 delightful excursions into the uses and abuses of words. Vivian Cook. Shadow Games. Glenn Cook.
And again, because I had selected title or author, I'm getting a number of authors with the name Cook, as opposed to books on the subject of cooking.
The Silver Spike, Glenn Cook. Fortress on the Sun, Paul Cook.
I'm going to choose Fortress on the Sun, double tap it.
Selected. Results. In progress.
It says in process.
Book detail.
Now I have book details, flicking to the right.
Fortress on the Sun, Paul Cook. Download.
And I have a choice for downloading. I have other information about the book, flicking to the right.
The time has come. You're thinking about going your own way, aren't you? Someone else said, our way. The Cloud Man responded.
So here's a little bit of text from the book, placed where the annotation would normally be, flicking to the right.
I have made it clear many, many times that I don't like my fate being in the hands of.
Flicking to the right.
This is the best opportunity humankind has had in 200 years.
Flicking
we
to
got
the right.
To try sometime. I think now is the
so
time.
I'm getting some of the information about it. I'm going to go flick we back till we get to the download button.
The time has come. Download button.
And when I double tap.
Download start book detail. Please wait. Alert. Download complete. Would you like to read
it? It's already downloaded
it.
Unzipped it and placed it onto the bookshelf. It took 0.6 seconds to do it.
Would you like to read it now? Download
and
time.
I could read it now.
Pardon
me, 3.08 seconds to download it.
No button.
I don't want to read it right now. I'm going to double tap on the no button.
Book detail. Fortress on the Sun.
And I'm going to choose.
Selected. Search. Tab. Bookshelf.
Bookshelf tab.
One of. Selected.
And now.
Bookshelf 4.
It says bookshelf 4, and it's been added.
Edit. Select author. Latest. Search. Cooking with Fire and Smoke. Face the Music. Jokes about. Selected. Fortress on the Sun. Paul Cook. Science fiction and fantasy
and
/ literature and fiction.
Here we have the new book added to the device. Again, this is an application called Read2Go. It's available off the App Store when installed, and you have a membership in the bookshare.org service. You can download, archive, and replay books, including putting in bookmarks on an as-needed basis. That completes this demonstration. It's just one of the ways that you can access books on your iPhone 4S.